This is a hot topic. Intro to Admin is going to review with you how you can configure a profile so that you can do personalization that's available for multiple users. So that's what this is going to go over. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is user settings and seeing what profile is assigned. So this is where you can indicate which user has which profile. So I'm going to open that up. So a lot of the times the default profile that's assigned is this business manager evaluation. That is, you know, more for like a high level, kind of more accounting based. So what a lot of times you want to do is assign a role that makes more sense if they're, you know, a sales order processor, purchasing person, or somebody in production. So under the person's user, you can go ahead. You can open that up, and then here's where you have the role. So using the lookup, you have access to all the available roles that are out of the box. And of course, you can just select one that's already there. So let's say Jen's a sales order person. She does a lot of the order entry with her users. So we make her a sales order process. We can indicate the language or the region. We can indicate if that profile is just for one company, or clear it and make it for all companies. If they're new to Business Central, it may make sense to turn on the teaching tips so that they can have little pop-up boxes that help to explain as they navigate around. So understanding the user settings and how to assign, that is step one. In an implementation, you typically want to assign a profile that makes sense to the user. This helps with their learning, it helps with user adoption, and it helps to make training a lot smoother as well. So that's the first thing, is seeing what profile is assigned. I'll show you how you can take an existing profile, you can make a copy of it so that you can make one unique to your company. And again, gear it more towards the features and the fields that you've determined are important to you. So I'm going to go and I'm going to navigate to profiles. And from here, I want to be able to make a copy so that I can, again, create something that's slimmed down and really, really focused so that my users will feel more comfortable as they navigate through. So Jen was assigned as being a sales order processor, and maybe I realized, you know what, that is something that is just a little bit too detailed for her. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy that profile. I typically want the profile ID. I like to have my company name in the beginning, so it's very obvious to me that it's something that I created. And then maybe I want order entry to be what they see when they log in, because that's how they refer to themselves. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do that. So now we can see here, I've got this Sabre order entry. I can see that you can set certain profiles as the default. You can indicate whether it's shown in the role explorer. But now what I'm going to do is I'm going to indicate that I want to customize the pages. So when I do this, another instance of Business Central pops up, and then I have the ability to be able to essentially see my role with a personalization look and feel to it. Do is using the orientation to Business Central YouTube series that we've done, or what you know about personalization, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to hide. I'm going to go ahead and add. I'm going to drill into the areas that I need. And I'm going to just start making this user experience something that makes a lot of sense for my users. So again, maybe I'm not using things like completely shipped for this group. Maybe I want my status to be moved over a little bit. I can hide or show things even within the fact box here if I want. I can keep drilling into the card pages. And I can keep personalizing. So I can show always, show when collapsed. So really, like I said, you're going to use all of the personalization capability that you're used to within Business Central and that you love. So once you're done all of your personalization in all of the areas that you want, you can go ahead and say done. The system lets us know that that customization has been successfully done and now it's basically saved under that profile. If I want to export that profile and put it into other environments where I'm testing, I can do that. I can set things as the default. If I want, if I drill into my profile, I can even do things like disable personalization. So if you have either a newer user or maybe a user where you've got more sensitive fields that you want to hide for them and then have them have to come to you to indicate why they should have access to them and treat personalization almost similar to a permission, you can do that within the profiles as well. So that again can be really, really helpful if you want to have a group of people where you want to give them their personalization, their look and feel, indicate what they can see and not see, and then not give them the ability to be able to just change and add that back if it suits your need. So once you've got that done, you can go back into your user settings. And then you would have the ability to be able to associate that new role that you created to that specific user. All of the customized profiles always show up at the top. So look for those up above and they're going to be based on your display name. So you can go ahead and say, okay. And then when that user logs in next, they will have that role view to be able to see it. And then of course here, if we look at my settings and we look at the role, I can see that role has been assigned. But if I drill in, they can also change that role and update it and see it if they want to as well. So again, really nice capability to be able to streamline, have people's look and feel start off as they start using that role. If they're doing personalization in their own session, then the profile then becomes their own and it won't be the same as the original. But this is a really great starting point, especially in new implementations or with new users, to onboard them and give them something that's really similar to the coworkers that they work with. Question on this feature or any of the great features in Business Central, please contact us using the information here.